A very good morning to all my dear students. Welcome to the web classes of English Standard 9. Reading is a pleasure and books are our best friends. With the statement, I would like to give you this advice that all of you should read the English text for at least 15 to 30 minutes daily, loudly. And this practice will definitely bring an improvement in your understanding. As we are growing up in this modern age, the learning of this language is going to help us a lot. Dear students, we have finished part 1 of lesson 2 and now it is the turn of part 2, the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. As the title reveals itself, we are going to talk about the Shehnai and Bismillah Khan as well in this biographical piece of writing. Biography is the piece of writing, dear students, that tells us about the whole life of a person. The Shehnai. These two words in the title suggest that we are going to know about a particular Shehnai owned by Bismillah Khan. Yes, in this story we are going to talk about a particular Shehnai, not only owned by Bismillah Khan but also created by himself. This Shehnai was created by Bismillah Khan himself. So before we start reading the text, would like to tell, what are we going to find in this story? We are going to read about the history of Shehnai, about an emperor Aurangzeb who banned the playing of pungi in his darbar, a barber who was born in the family of traditional Muslim musicians and later became the creator of Shehnai, who improved upon the sound of pungi, and how does Shehnai get its name? Shehnai, considered as an auspicious instrument and was included in nobat. Nobat means 9 musical instruments played in the royal courts in that age. Then we will read about Bismillah Khan, who had been lovingly called by many names like Ustad Bismillah Khan, Khan Sahab, etc. And this person is given the credit to bring Shehnai to the classical stage or classical level. Now we are going to read the text. Hope all of you have the books in hands. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called pungi in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Pungi became the generic name for reed noisemakers. Few had thought that it would one day be revived. A barber of a family of professional musicians who had access to the royal palace decided to improve the tonal quality of the pungi. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the pungi and made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. When he played on it, closing and opening some of these holes, soft and melodious sounds were produced. He played the instrument before royalty and everyone was impressed. The instrument so different from the pungi had to be given a new name. As the story goes, since it was first played in the Shah's chambers and was played by a Nai barber, the instrument was named the Shehnai. Dear students, as you can see the physical difference between pungi and Shehnai in your books. So this paragraph says, tells us that in this biographical sketch of Bismillah Khan, we are told that the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb had given orders of banning the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi in his palace. Why? Why he put a restriction on playing of Pungi? Because it didn't produce a pleasant sound. In fact, Pungi produced a shrill, sharp, loud sound that was not liked by many. Pungi became a common name that was given to any musical instrument made of reed. Means, whatever musical instrument made of reed were all called by the same name, Pungi. They were considered noisemakers as they didn't produce the pleasant sounds. No one had ever thought that one day the instrument would be restored, renewed, would be given a new life and become popular. Yes, this person created this magic. All this happened due to a barber who used to visit the royal palace. It was he who decided to improve the tonal quality of the instrument so that it made a pleasant sound. What did he do to do so? First of all, he picked up a pipe. He chose a pipe, in fact, with a hollow stem, which was comparatively longer and broader than the traditional pungi. Then he made 7 holes in it and played it by closing and opening some of these holes so that a soft and melodious sound could be produced. Now he decided to play the modified form of this pungi in the royal court before the royalty. All those who listened to this new instrument were impressed. They decided to call this instrument the Shehnai. So, dear student, a question arises here. How does Shehnai get its name? So, the story goes like this. Because it was first played in the Shah's chamber, and the person who played was a Nai, barber, we say it in English. That is why the instrument has been called Shehnai. Look at the second paragraph. The sound of the Shehnai began to be considered auspicious, and for this reason, it is still played in temples and is an indispensable component of any North Indian wedding. In the past, the Shehnai was part of the Naubat, or traditional ensemble of 9 instruments found at royal courts. Till recently, it was used only in temples and weddings. The credit for bringing this instrument onto the classical stage goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan. So this paragraph tells us that once the Shehnai was welcomed in the royal court, royal chamber, Shahi Darbar, and people loved its sound, jaise hi logo ne iski awaaz ko sunna pasand kiya, it not only became popular but came to be considered auspicious too. ये ना सिर्फ प्रसिद्ध हुई बल्कि इसे शुभ माना जाने लगा. दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द रीजन्स वाई दिस शहनाई इज प्लेड इन टेम्पल्स एंड इज कंसीडर्ड अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ अ नॉर्थ इंडियन वेडिंग म्यूजिक. इन द एंशियंट डेज शहनाई वॉज ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड इन नौबत. So for a long time, the shehnai was, the pungi was restricted to temples and weddings only. It was much later that it was brought on the stage as a classical instrument. The credit for making it popular on the stage goes to only Ustad Bismillah Khan. So till here, in these first two paragraphs, we have been told about the history of Shehnai. What was Shehnai in the beginning? How does it get its new name? And how does it get popularity? Dear students, I want you to read this much for the day. And don't forget to maintain the habit of reading English for at least 20 to 30 minutes. Thank you. Have a nice day. We will meet tomorrow.